You know, the worst thing you could do to a person is take away their peanuts. Okay, and I'm not going to do that. I'm just going to talk about what type of peanuts you should focus more on. Because if you end up buying the wrong type of peanuts or peanut butter, you may find that your health is going to suffer. There's this one ingredient in 80% of all peanut butter. You don't want it in your body. And if you eat the right type of peanut butter or peanuts, I don't think there's going to be a lot of health issues, but I recently started the carnivore diet just to test it out for a couple of weeks. From the elimination of the nuts, my bloating went away. So I'm not going back to peanuts. You can if it doesn't bloat you. But I have also gone back to vegetables as well. So my diet right now is a combination. It's like 50% carnivore and 50% plant-based because I do like my salads. But let's talk about the difference between conventional peanut butter or peanuts. Now, when you're consuming conventional peanuts, unfortunately, peanuts are probably one of the most heavily sprayed with pesticides and insecticides, and especially fungicides, out of many different things that you might eat. A peanut is not an actual nut, it's a legume. And so when they spray, it gets into soil and it gets down into where the peanut is. And this peanut shell is very, very thin. Unlike a walnut, which has a hard shell, you really need to do organic peanuts or peanut butter. Okay, that's number one. There's also an herbicide called glyphosate, which can act like an antibiotic. It's in a lot of different GMO foods. And that's been known to be in peanuts simply because they rotate the crops from a GMO food to a peanut back and forth. I think it's cottonseed or it could be canola. I'm not 100% sure. The other thing is you must read the label because if it says hydrogenated anything, don't consume that. Now, maybe you've heard of partially hydrogenated, which gave you all these trans fats. Well, what's the difference between hydrogenated and partially hydrogenated? Really, I think from my own viewpoint, it's very, very similar. Even though they say that hydrogenated doesn't have the trans fats, you're basically using the same process of adding hydrogens under high heat, and then it becomes partially hydrogenated, and then they leave it in longer, and then becomes fully hydrogenated. And so you want to avoid anything that says hydrogenated or partially hydrogenated. Also, they sneak in vegetable oils, which are not vegetable oils, they're seed oils. They put this in the peanut butter. So you just don't want to even have that in your body. The other thing that slips in there is this sugar. Sometimes family members will buy peanut butter, right? And I'll start consuming it on something. I'm like, wow, this is really good. And I'm like, oh, let me read the label. This is why it's so good, because it has sugar in it. But there's one more ingredient that's a carcinogen. It can increase the risk of certain cancers by 46%. And that ingredient is monoglycerides. There's a French study that links it to cancer. So we don't want that in our diets. And they use it just to kind of break things up so you don't have that layer of oil at the top. So if you find a peanut butter that has all of those factors, I would upgrade to a better quality peanut butter. Okay, peanuts and salt, pretty natural. If we want to improve it more, we want organic peanuts and sea salt. If we want to improve it even a little bit more, I would recommend Valencia organic peanuts. They're the ones that have the least amount of potential aflatoxin, which is a toxin from certain molds that can grow on peanuts, which is very, very damaging to the liver. And they use sea salt, which is better than regular table salt. Sometimes it's really hard to not overdo it with peanuts or peanut butter. I know if I sit down and start eating peanuts, I will pretty much eat the whole bag. And I feel this like heavy feeling underneath my right rib cage. That's my gallbladder trying to digest these fats. One more point about peanuts and peanut butter. If you can have them with the meal, that's better than a snack, especially if you're snacking late at night, because anything that you consume of any significance as far as calories can spike the insulin. And if you're into intermittent fasting, nuts are a dangerous item to have around, especially late at night. Now, since we're on the topic of nuts, if you have not seen my video on walnuts, you might want to check that out. I put it up right here.